Schema markup is a way of providing search engines context about your website. If implemented correctly, it can play a big role in helping your site stand out among Google search results. Today, I'm going to walk through the process of how you can add schema markup to your Gatsby site. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. Today, we're going to walk through how to implement schema markup on your Gatsby site. For today's video, I'm assuming that you're already familiar with what schema markup is and the benefits it can bring to your site. If you're not familiar with schema markup, I would encourage you to watch one of my previous videos where I talk about the SEO benefits of adding schema markup. If you're wanting to follow along with today's demo, all you need is a code editor and a terminal of some kind and the Gatsby framework installed. So let's get started. So we have Visual Studio open. We'll open up a terminal and then change to our project directory. Then we'll run the Gatsby new command to create an out-of-the-box Gatsby site using their default starter project. While it finishes installing, let me tell you a little bit more about the scenario that we're going to build. We're going to add the organization schema type to our homepage. The organization schema type is something I recommend for almost every website. It's especially useful for businesses to provide additional information like contact information and just basic description to search providers. You only need to include it on one page of your site. And so normally that is either the homepage or maybe a contact us page. So now let's open our project that we just created. And then we'll open up our SEO component in the components directory. The SEO component is added as part of the Gatsby default starter project, and it uses the helmet component. The helmet component is a way you can easily include meta titles and descriptions and other meta tags and include links and script tags and things like that, things that you'll want on every single page. Instead of hard coding our schema in the SEO component, we're going to add a parameter to the component. We'll just name it schema markup. And then we'll go down to our helmet tag and we're going to put it inside the tags. And so we'll create our closing tag. We want to wrap our script tag with some conditional logic. Since we're not going to be using this on every single page, we want to check, make sure a value exists. So we'll add our script tag with the type of application/ld+json. There's several formats you can use to add schema markup, but we're going to use JSON-LD. Next, we'll write our code to write out our schema markup in the JSON-LD format. So we'll use the json.stringify command, and then we'll pass it our variable schema markup, which is a JSON object. Next, we need to modify our homepage or whatever page that we're adding the schema markup to. So we open up our index.js in the pages folder. Then we need to change the React component from a presentation component to a function component. To do that, we'll add a opening bracket and then a return statement before the opening parentheses of the rendering section, and then a closing bracket at the end. Then we'll add our variable for our schema markup. We'll just stub it out for now. Then we'll fill it up later with the actual markup. And then we'll pass the value of the schema variable to our schema markup parameter on our SEO component. Now let's open up a web browser and then do a search for schema markup generator. And the first item in the list is going to be a schema markup generator tool offered by technicalseo.com. This tool is a great way to generate the schema for several different schema types. We'll choose organization, and then we'll leave the organization type at organization. We'll enter our name, in my case, Guiding Digital, and then I'll enter my website's URL. And then the URL to my site's logo. And then it allows you to add contacts as well. For now, we're just going to use this basic information. So once you have everything entered, you can hit the blue copy icon and we'll copy the generated code for you. Then switch back to Visual Studio and we're going to paste in our code that we copied from the generator tool. So paste it in and we'll get rid of the opening and closing script tags that included. We're going to do one more thing before we test our markup. We're going to add a description property, and then we're going to pull in the description and the site URL from the global configuration in the Gatsby config file. We've added our description property. So now let's go to our Gatsby config file, and we're going to add to the site metadata section the site URL property. And I'm going to give it a value of my website URL, www.guidingdigital.com. Now I'm going to go back to my index page. Then I'm going to add imports for the use static query and GraphQL modules. Then I'm going to add my GraphQL static query. I'm going to just copy and paste so you don't have to watch me type it all out. It's a simple query that gets the description and site URL from the site's site metadata section. Now I'm going to go down to my schema variable where I have my schema markup. And then I'm going to change the description to pull in the value from my query. So site.siteMetadata.description. And then I'm going to do the same thing for the URL. Site.siteMetadata.siteURL. Now we're ready to test our changes. We'll save our changes, and then we'll open up a terminal and run the Gatsby develop command to start a local instance of our website. And then we'll go to the link it gives us, localhost port 8000 in the web browser. And then we'll spec the source. And then we'll go to the head section. And if you go down to the bottom of the head section, you'll see the script tag of type application JSON-LD. And then if we open the script tag, then we see our expected organization schema markup with the correct description and the site URL pulled in. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like and make sure to subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.